start off, I would like to thank the Mayor Nicholson, City Engineer Mike Lane, Attorney Michael Vanderberg, Manager Craig Stephenson, Commissioner Rathburn, Commissioner Austin, and Commissioner Moore, Commissioner Chapman, and City Clerk Mark Austin for taking your time to be and watch us present our slides to you and watch us tell you what we think we should do. Start off, my name is Jim Markle.
My name is Chandler Lake.
I'm Gary Bailey.
My name is Kayla Beans.
And my name is Lynn Denning.
This is our project about why we should switch the metric system.
We decided to put down what we know and a small recap. For one, we wanted to let you know, everybody in the world except these three countries, which are in red, that is us, the United States, Myanmar, and a small little red dot in Africa, Liberia. What is the metric system, you ask? Metric system, it's really simple. It's a decimal-based system. It's multiples of 10, 10 base in every measurement. It was created by an Englishman named John Wilkinson, or no, Wilkins. He was a bishop, I think around the 1700s, a decimal-based system to replace the one that he uses now, which is what we use, which was based off random measurements. For instance, a foot was literally just the length of your foot until it was standardized to 12 inches. France eventually created a multinational decimal-based system, which later spread and was edited and is now the one we use today. And there's been many chances for us to switch and many acts that have been passed, which are the way committees too, sorry. In the 1800s, we tried to switch. People didn't like it, so we never did it. And the U.S. passed the Metric Conversion Act in 1972, and still yet to convert. It was supposed to be all done before the turn of the century, and it was never done. So, continuing on. The metric system uses a system of decimals that span through every measurement. And those are kilo, well there's more, but these are the basic ones. There's kilo, which means 1,000. Hecto, which means 100, and deca, which means 10, and then you have your base unit, which is 1, then you have deci, which is 1/10, you have centi, which means 1/100, which you probably heard of centimeter, I think everyone's heard of that, and milli, which means 1/1000, 1/1000, I need 1 this one.
1/1000. Switched the metric system yet? Well, technically we kind of have switched the metric system. They are teaching us in school, they're teaching both the English system and the metric system, but there's also immigration rising in the U.S., so we're trying to struggle with whether to teach the metric system or to stay with the English system. And we do use the metric system, but it is not mandated. So we have integrated it into our lifestyles, such as packaging food differently, we use it in field work, etc., etc. How would the U.S. switch the metric system? We were thinking of a gradual change. A gradual change wouldn't cost a bunch of money like at first, so it would be pretty easy, and adults would have time to accustom to the metric system, so they wouldn't just be like, bam, it's the metric system. It wouldn't be much of a problem, and people who use the metric system on a daily basis would already know it, and people who don't like have time to object it or to learn it. And there are also ways on how to make a gradual change, like street signs, as I said before, packaging food differently, etc., etc., teaching little kids.
16 ounces equals 1 pound. Why one of the odd numbers? So why have 16 equals 1 pound? Why not have like 10 ounces equals 1 pound? Because that's how the metric system is. It's just much more simple. If you learn metric, it's just adding 10 and learning the prefixes. It would also be very monumental. It would, since it's a smaller city, I think it'd be easier since we don't have tons of people to persuade. So we would be able to teach it easier. Here we go.
This is how the metric system works. It has multiple different units for measurements, and they're also like really simple. They convert because of a base of 10. You have a channel listed, the kilo, hecto, deca, centi, milli, etc., etc. There are also different ones like micro and nano, but they work on a base of 10. And there are also base units for measurement, such as volume for liters, grams for mass, and meters for length.
How hard could it be to convert gallons of milk or gasoline to liters, and why haven't we done this? I think it would be fairly easy to do it because we already have half gallons, so I don't have 2 liters or 4 liters. Also, I personally think it wouldn't be too hard to switch because we're taught a little bit of measurement in school. But I see if we're such a good country as people say, why would we switch to what others do? But I think we haven't switched because people that are older, it would be really hard for them to learn a new thing. Here's liters of milk and liters of gasoline. Some people think it costs too much to change the infrastructure. We could just use our old infrastructure and just change the bottom. I don't think it would cost too much. I think it's a lot easier to convert the metric system rather than standard. All you have to do is move the decimal or standard. You have to multiply. An example of how the dual systems have failed us in the past would be the Mars orbiter, which crashed because of failed calculations of the SI system and the metric system. These are our opinions. My opinion, I think we should switch over time, like 60 or 70 years, just switch totally, teach it in schools. I think, after if we teach it for that long, all the older people, that would be some reason why we didn't switch, would be to a better place. And so everybody would already know the metric system pretty well. And I think it'd be easier to convert too.
On my opinion towards this, I do believe that the metric system is very simple. It's a lot easier, and anybody who can count can use it. And I'm pretty sure all of you can count. I do believe the metric system should be our primary system. I honestly know this system better than I know our own system that we use now. And things like road signs. We're not saying just like take them down and then add new ones. We're saying maybe add a second panel to them that says kilometers. And you know, like a lot of cars already have fitted kilometers per hour in their speedometers. So it's not this huge deal for that. I believe that Ponca City, we are a small city as I said. It's not that big of a change for us, but it would be big for the United States. And that's why I think we should start it. We should set an example for other cities in Oklahoma and let it spread. If it works well for us, it might work well for other cities, and it would start to spread. And I believe it will work well. There's a lot of economic benefits that go in with it, such as, say, we're doing business with another country. Our conversions are very precise. And we, and a lot of them could end up in numbers that span miles long. So it could really get us out of a lot of product for a lot less money. And think of, like Eric said, it would be monumental. It's a big change. I mean, you know, the city's never been heard before. I mean, I'm pretty sure at least one of you has heard of the Metric Highway in Arizona. That uses the kilometers per hour. Well, that's just a highway. We're talking about gradually changing the entire city. Not instantly, but like through like decades and start to move towards metric. And this is a relatively unsteady change. Not many people looked into it because many people view our system as a sign of American independence. But what are we supposed to do? Wait for everybody to switch to our system? It doesn't work like that. I honestly do think we really should change it.
This is my opinion, and I do believe that we should make the switch to metric system because of the great economic benefits that it could have and its simplicity of use. Our trade and communication with other countries would like simplify it like many times, and it makes it easier with itself with the convergence. It's pretty much easier. And like Chandler said, I know the metric system better than I knew this system. I believe the metric system is the US's future.
This is my opinion, and I believe that we should make the switch. It would eliminate confusion, and we would have to, we wouldn't have to convert to our partner's measurement system. So here's an example. If we were on the phone with someone, and we were talking about, say, like oil pipelines, if someone gave us some measurements, we say it takes a minute to convert from metric system to SI, that's in like 1 minute. So if you have a 50-minute conversation and he gives you 20 different problems, that's 20 minutes. That's only 30 minutes left, but 20 minutes you could spend talking about more stuff. Also, cars in the UK, they don't have miles per hour on the speedometers, because why would they? So they wouldn't really use like American muscle cars really, that don't have the integrated kilometers per hour. So if we would all switch, we could make revenue from our cars being imported to the, or exported to the UK, and yeah.
This is my opinion, and in my opinion, I strongly believe we should switch to the metric system because of the rising rate of immigration. I did have some. I talked with some sources of mine, and I asked them what they think about switching the metric system and how hard it was to convert from standard to system and metric system in your job. And the first person I talked to was my dad, and he said that when you are working the oil field, which he's a construction manager, and he has people to convert from standard to metric for himself, but he does have to check himself to make sure it is correct, just so they don't have a miscalculation. Since he does work in the oil field, he has to work with mass, converting that from standard to metric. He has to work with weight, converting that, and he also has to work with length. Which converting all three of those in such a short amount of time, they have to get that, let's say they've got about 3 months to get a whole well up and running. And they gotta convert that and make sure it's all proper and ready to go. That's a lot to do. So the next person I talked to was my Uncle Kevin, which I talked to him through text because he lives in another city. But he's an electrician. And he says that if he orders something from a different country, it comes in metric. Say, I'm not talking about Liberia or Myanmar, I'm talking about Europe. He's converting basically metric to standard all over again, as long as my dad. And I believe he's working in a hotel right, or working to get a hotel up and running. So getting the hotel up and running with all those metric people to standard conversion is pretty hard. But I have one more thing to say is that when we trade or when we buy or sell to other countries such as Europe or Asia that are using the metric system, they're actually getting more product, like let's say hay or wheat, they're getting more product for less amount of money. So basically they're cheating us. We would be having, we would probably have more money right now if we switched to the metric system than we would right now staying in the standard system because of the trade and immigration. And it would bring a lot of tourism in. But with us selling our products to Europe, basically they're giving us less money than we should, and we wouldn't be as much in debt as we would be right now if we had more money from Europe. So, it's my opinion.
In the end, I think we should switch the metric system so we wouldn't have to convert back and forth all the time. It would make trade with other countries easier.
Before we get into questions and answers, there are a couple facts that I want to share with you. I looked this up, and there's many, even though it's an unsteady change, there is some things that have been done. And I looked it up, and apparently the United States, on average, loses about $6.8 billion every year due to what Drew said about cheating out of the system. And this change would mostly benefit small businesses, as they are likely to get products from other countries, such as foreign automobiles. They're made in metric, and so we have to use them in metric. And that's the problem. If you were to make one miscalculation, that those home vehicles would probably have to be called back due to wrong measurements, and it could cause accidents and loss of life, and that's not something we want. Like Nissan, Toyota, really popular Japanese automobiles. Japan uses the metric system. If you bring them over here, then the mechanics and people who work on those have to use metric, and that's a problem. Because what happens if they have a miscalculation? Most calculators will, a lot of calculators won't give you the whole number, they'll give you the rounded up number, and that's a problem because it has to be precise. And another thing, you guys have anything? Alright, the British, in 1968, the British Industry Foundation, which I don't know their actual name, but their industry foundation, did an experiment and learned that when trading with the United States, they gained about 5 billion pounds a year. And that's a lot for that time. And that's about $7.2 billion. And that's a lot. And think about this. Would you rather, like, it's been estimated that a change to the metric system completely would cost about $370 million. And that's an all-at-once change. That's why we're requesting a gradual change. But would you rather spend all that money at once or keep losing the amount of money that we lose right now every year? You're going to make more money by changing in the long run than you are now. We're losing money every year just due to this. One thing, if we were to switch to the metric system, if the country was to switch to the metric system, everything through the schools, our school motto is preparing to live and work in a global society. It's on our ID badges. How are we supposed to work in a global society where we use something different than the rest of the world? It makes it a lot harder.
thank you for listening to us, and I hope that we have maybe changed one of your opinions or strengthened your opinions in the metric system. And so, question time. Yeah. Anyone have any questions?
Well, you say 60 or 70 years to make the transition, so how long have we been in the process? So we're not even through the first 70 years.
Problem is, like I said, we do have an integrated in our lifestyle. Like, medicine is done in milligrams and cubic centimeters. And you don't say a 2 gallon thing of soda, you say 2 liter. It's a lot of things that we don't really pay attention to that we've already sort of switched to. And it's not as big as a change as most people will think. And that's probably why a lot of people oppose this idea, is because it seems like a huge change, but it's really not. It's you're really just strengthening what we already started. And the 60-70 year change is due to people who really do not want to do it because they don't have, a lot of people don't have the capability of using it because they didn't learn it in school. And we did learn it in school, and like a lot of us, I don't know most of the conversions or most of the units for System International, which is the use right now. I barely know some of the numbers. Like the main thing I know that I memorized is miles 5,280 feet. Well, why can't it be 5,000 feet? Like things like that. It's really complicated.
So my question.
Yeah.
You're talking about a 60 or 70 year time frame. Let's say 70 years, so how long have we been in this process of making these gradual changes? Because we have made some changes, right?
Yes, we have, and we integrated it into things like food, and we already have the new labels. I think we've been in this process since about the 70s, where we started adding new labels as immigration increases, because like Canada, Mexico, those two countries use it, and we're getting a lot of Mexican immigrants. And so, they're asymmetric. And so, and we're like the only major country that uses SI. And so that can be a problem for them, especially because this is a culturally diverse country because we get immigration from every country. But they're having to learn our system. But if we were to eliminate this system, it would make things a lot easier and make it, like someone said, tourism, it's a big deal. And if we were the first city to switch to this, the city would probably get a lot more tourism. Probably get like a million elementary city or something like that.
So we've been in this process since the mid-70s, and so it's 40 years later, so we've got another 30 years on the original 70, right? So we're gradually making those changes.
Yeah.
That was just like an estimate.
I'm just telling you. So the situation is, you guys have grown up in a society where it's like this, instant, right? It takes time, and so I think we're on a process, we're on a path to make those things happen. So just you got to keep pushing through that process, that's all I'm saying. And we'll take those changes and continue to occur. And I think they'll occur before I'm finished here on Earth, but maybe not from there.
I do realize the gradual change, but it's not like we're gonna switch the side in the room. It's not like we're gonna switch from the right side to the left side. And have you ever heard the saying, you can't teach a dog the old dog new tricks? That seems wrong. You can't teach a dog the old dog new tricks.
They say going down the road at 100 kilometers per hour, which estimated is around 70 miles per hour. Then how are you going to know how fast he's going or where he is? Because he's going to be like a kilometer away from you, you're not going to know that. That's why we're saying gradual change. We're not saying change all the signs at once. We're saying add to and then take a little later, which would be, it would save money, be a lot easier. Instead of taking out old ones and putting new ones, you add to them. And later, when everybody's already used to it, it's more likely to want to happen. You can switch it. And we're not saying we want to do it right away. I mean, a lot of people are already accustomed to our system today. So law enforcement can ask about.
That's an issue there. So those are things we have to think about.
My dad, he has two police cars, which is a Dodge Charger and a Chevy Impala. Almost all automobiles have an integrated kilometers per hour switch for international use. In the Charger, you can press a button and it switches your speedometer to kilometers per hour. And it is in the signs. For those who want to use the system we have today, they can. And for those who don't, they can still see the kilometers per hour next to it. And with that, we'll be able to learn the conversion between measurements. Like say highway, the speed is for kilometers per hour at first is going to be a lot more precise because 75 miles per hour, which I think is average for highways, it's not exactly a number of kilometers per hour, which is a bit of a problem now. That's a few issues that might happen, but it'll get a lot easier as time goes on. And law enforcement, if we're not, for people, police officers, if that's included, if people do start to become accustomed to the system. And once everybody's sort of used to it, you can hold a vote and we can start to switch. And if the majority goes for metric, then we can start to take out, not take everything at once. Like things that might be, ammunition is already measured in millimeters. That's something that they already use, that they don't know that, and not many people pay attention to. Right? 9mm bullet, it's 9mm. That's almost a centimeter. But there's a lot of things that they don't realize that it's already in their job.
So tell me this, what's the biggest issue that you think needs to be changed? We're talking about traffic, which is very difficult because that's a nationwide issue. You got to do that probably at one time. And of course, you know, the federal government did away with the meth report in the 80s. So there's no governing body that I know of the federal government. But, you know, there's other things.
For one, about traffic, there is no law mandating a single system of measurement. The industry is already mandating metric. That's already something that's
all the statutes first.
Statutes.
Yeah, the laws. Speed is 20x miles per hour.
I honestly didn't know that.
Well, I'm just saying, but those are, and you wouldn't know that. I'm just saying. What to think about?
Well, the main thing you can start doing the law books like that is you can start adding frequencies with some kilometers per hour. That's sort of how it will work at first, which is what we do for speed labels. I mean, a gallon is 3.7 liters. So you see that on your gallon screen when you buy Rollins or Walmart or whatever. And traffic. It's not like stoplights are going to be changed. I mean, that's something that isn't really used for that. But road signs, I know that's a big deal because that costs a lot of money. I don't want to replace the road signs because it is sort of something that this is our country. I want to add to it though because it's harder for people to start to accustom to the issue here and become citizens because that's really hard to do to get used to that system because there's so many different random measurements.
Are there any states or communities that have dual signage?
Dual signage.
Like talking about miles per hour and miles per hour.
I don't know. I haven't done any research on that.
You mentioned a total change all at once with $300 and some odd million dollars.
$370 million. this is relatively recent change, and I got this from different documents. And so this is most likely incorrect. Probably not building the building. That's a lot of money.
I'm getting to more further science than maybe say for his college.
I just wanted to add something real quick to the neuroscience. If you didn't want to make any neuroscience, you can actually, I bet you could get recycled. You can use some recycled products to make neuroscience. And that would actually, I believe, would save more money than just building a whole new neuroscience.
That way you don't waste any materials.
That is great to make.
I know we have the giant oil window, which is a big economic failure. What happens when you're doing business with another country and the conversion goes up and something you've made or something you're giving them, you end up getting more money or something breaks down? Like, maybe it was Three Mile Island, nuclear power plant. Have problems due to incorrect conversions, and that's really quite a big tragedy. Especially with power plant, it's a very complex equipment. It's a big deal here, and so it's a lot of international relationships. And if we were to switch, if we were to start to switch, it would make it a lot easier for international trade, and it might even help with like gas prices.
I'm not gonna argue the point, but we don't have a jurisdiction, so that's a part of government issue.
And the thing about setting an example, there's a very high chance that this would actually work if it was done. It's less, and like I said, like nicknames like Metric City, if we were to change, it would really be famous. For things like this, I mean, that would increase tourism.
It would probably bring a lot of money that we used to. I'm gonna use a kid word, but you know, I'm still a kid. Fancy up our city. fancy up our city, you know, where you would change or like rebuild some buildings that have fallen down. Especially if you're working in the nuclear business, you have to be careful.
better than Europe. And it's pretty cool to be going 100 kilometers an hour. You're on Zoom 60. That's kind of cool. Looking into this, talk about immigration in the United States. We like to think that we're the greatest country on earth, that people want to migrate here. So if they want to migrate here, they must like what's here. So why don't we change everybody else? We're the greatest country on earth. Why don't we change everybody else to a change like this?
I think it's because right now there is a lot of conflict in the European countries, and they felt like, I learned this in history just yesterday, and it literally expanded my mind to new levels. But my history teacher made a point that they come here because they know the Bill of Rights. They have freedom of speech. They have freedom of assembly. They have the right to bear arms to protect themselves from things that shouldn't be happening. In other countries, they probably, like in their constitution, they only probably have about two rights. That's, I believe, is to be there and to live. And so with them coming over here, I believe it's because they want to be who they want. They want to be themselves. They don't want to be somebody else who's following the crowd. They want to speak their mind. They want to speak up. And so they will be coming here for that. And they, if they only wear metric in their country, and they come over here and there are all these standard systems, they wouldn't be having a lot of trouble. So they probably have to go to a class to teach them that. But,
See, when I travel to a fourth country, I don't expect them to switch to English. I expect to speak their language. I expect them to learn our language, speak our language for their system. And that's just an expectation. You go to China or Japan or Europe or South America, you're their country, it's their laws, it's their business.
I don't think it's possible that we can wait for them to switch to our system. There's too many countries that have already adopted the system. There's too many countries that have already adopted it. I do believe that it would save a lot of money. It would help a lot of local businesses and create jobs. And yes, what you said, we could really scale. That population would increase. We'd have money to build new homes, things like that.
Well, I'm going to wrap it up. We want to say thank you to you all for being here and letting us present our opinions. Thank you.
I want to say congratulations to you on this project. It's pretty impressive. And you did a super job. I'm really pleased with you. You're very impressive, great, smart young kids. Really appreciate you coming and doing this. I'm glad to see you get to the microphone and get a chance to do some public speaking, because I've seen so many people, even adults, that cannot get through a group in front of a group and speak. So you're getting some wonderful training. Your teachers are doing you a great, great job, a great service. I'm really proud of you. Thank you so much.